Warzone has always had handfuls of issues within its game, but for the most part, it's always been fun. Just recently, for a lot of players, including myself, I've lost interest in Warzone and just haven't had fun while playing it. I logged in last night to get some gameplay for this video and just did not have fun whatsoever. And the second I finished playing, like the 30 seconds of Warzone that I did, I just went back to Cold War and played 6v6 and just didn't even think about playing Warzone whatsoever. And there's a couple issues of why Warzone isn't amazing anymore, and it used to be. That's the thing that kind of hits hardest the most, is Warzone used to be incredible. And I was a denier for so long of the major issues in Warzone that I was like, you know what, these are issues I don't care about. I love the game. I'm gonna pretend like they're not a thing. But just recently, I've kind of realized that I was wrong back then. And now that my perspective has changed a little, I have a different outlook on the situation. As always, let me know in the comment section down below what you guys agree and disagree with in the video, and we can have some conversations discussing this topic down below. And of course, the background gameplay is Cold War, because the Warzone gameplay that I played last night, I just did not have fun whatsoever. And I think about the two games that I played in total, I think I might have gotten 3 kills total and then just did not have fun for the rest. Anyway, I think the biggest thing that caused Warzone's downfall is the Cold War integration. Now, in theory, there's nothing wrong with it whatsoever, but when it launched, it was unfinished. We didn't have completely finished weapons in the game. The camos were horrible, and really, the camos still are pretty bad for the Cold War weapons within Warzone. And it was completely unbalanced, where the Cold War guns dominated the game. And even to this day, minus the AMAX meta, the Cold War weapons still outclass the Modern Warfare weapons by a lot. And this isn't strictly just a Cold War issue. I think regardless of what title was integrated into Warzone, I think any Call of Duty title would have caused this issue. So if for some reason Cold War was next year and Sledgehammer's Vanguard was this year, I think we would see the same issues as long as it was on a different engine. But that's the main thing, is both Cold War and Modern Warfare use different engines. So when you use weapons in Cold War, they feel super smooth, but then when you take those Cold War weapons and put them into Warzone, even though Modern Warfare and Warzone have the superior engine, because they're not, like, because the guns aren't built for this engine originally, they feel completely off and very clunky. And I was watching in my YouTube recommended a video from Dr. Disrespect and him and Z-Laner playing Warzone before the Cold War integration happened, and the game just looks so much smoother. When the Warzone was literally just Modern Warfare weapons, Warzone was just so smooth, and sure, there were some things unbalanced and a little bit broken, but everything was still viable. You could still use the Odin, and you can even use the Odin today, but if you have the Odin and you come across a Pharah, or even still after all the nerfs, the FFAR, you are going to get absolutely just destroyed by the Cold War weapons. And it feels so weird having weapons from one Call of Duty mix with weapons from another Call of Duty, at least when they use different engines. Because if you guys have played a lot of Cold War and a lot of Modern Warfare and a lot of Warzone, you'll know that the Cold War weapons, they feel good in Cold War. The movement is fine. Sure, we don't have the tactical sprint like we do in Modern Warfare, and some of the movement engines is a little bit different, but the Cold War weapons feel so smooth and arcadey within Cold War. But then you bring those over to Modern Warfare and they're clunky and slow and they feel awkward. Even during normal animations with the weapons from Cold War and Warzone, something just feels off. And if you haven't played Cold War, you won't notice this whatsoever if you're a free-to-play Warzone player. But if you are a player who's bought and played Cold War, you will notice the difference, even just by watching gameplay of someone use it. Also, if the Cold War integration never happened, Warzone would still be extremely fun to play. Sure, Activision wouldn't be making millions off of Cold War bundles, so we'd be force-fed a bunch of Modern Warfare weapon bundles, but Warzone would just seem so much more complete with just Warzone weapons and no Cold War integration whatsoever. It feels weird to think that Warzone before the Cold War integration felt more completed and more finished and more uniform than the Cold War integration. It feels like the Cold War integration was almost a step back. And I love being able to use the Krig 6 and a bunch of weapons from Cold War within Modern Warfare, but honestly, I could do without the integration. And of course, a map change is something that would also keep the game fresh. If we saw a new map after the nuke event of Verdansk, I think the game would be very refreshing and there'd be lots of replayability. Even though that Verdansk 1984 changed Verdansk quite dramatically, it still feels the exact same, and there's not a lot that you can do once you've explored all the new locations and what you've gotten used to everything. It just plays the same. Now, I used to be on the train of, we don't need a new map. Verdansk is a great map, and I can't wait to see Verdansk during the Cold War. But I didn't think about the replayability factor. When I hop onto Warzone and play, at least recently, I'll log on and play, and it's the same experience I had when Warzone first started. Sure, some of the points of interest are slightly different, but the gameplay and just the way that the game flows is the exact same, which would be cool to see a new map change in the future. Now, the one thing I'm hoping with World War II Vanguard is it actually does play as the leaks suggest, where it's gonna play on the Modern Warfare 2019 engine, which means if Warzone gets any World War II integration to it, the World War II integration will feel uniform because it's on the same engine. I really think that the biggest issue with the Cold War integration is the differences of engines between Warzone and Cold War. If the engines were the same, I don't think we would have an issue whatsoever because the guns would play and perform the exact same way in multiplayer as they would in Warzone. Very similar to what Modern Warfare did during Modern Warfare's Warzone. One thing that I also think is slightly killing off Warzone and is stopping it from being amazing is the Fortnite effect. And a lot of you guys might have heard this in very old videos of mine if you've been on the channel for a long time, but the Fortnite effect is where Fortnite enacts either too little or too much change and it ends off killing the game. Look at what happened in Fortnite in general. Of course, you had kids overrun it, and that also diminished the popularity of the game for the older audiences, but Warzone just strayed too far from what worked, and Warzone has become decreasingly popular over the past years. And Warzone is following in the footsteps of Fortnite. Now, it could also be people are just getting tired and burnt out of playing Battle Royale games over and over again, and Warzone really doesn't have enough map changes for a static Battle Royale experience to be exciting every time you play it. Now, if you're a player that absolutely enjoys the game, I am super happy for you. I wish that I enjoyed the game as much as I once did, because I would play Warzone for hours on end with Dorito Thief and Special Service, and we'd get win after win and have fun, but we just don't enjoy the game like that anymore. So if you still are, enjoy it for as long as you can, because it's sweet while you're playing it and it's sour once you kind of lose that honeymoon phase for the game and you stop seeing it through rose-tinted glasses. But I think I really just think Battle Royale games are becoming increasingly unpopular, especially in the Call of Duty terms. Now, lots of people enjoy Warzone, and I understand that, and there's millions of free-to-play players where it's the only Call of Duty experience they can play, but as someone who's been playing Call of Duty for a long time, I've really been enjoying the 6v6 and like the standard Call of Duty game modes once again. During Modern Warfare, I like branching out to go to Ground War and all of those crazy and wacky game modes that they added into Modern Warfare. But as of recently, I've just really been enjoying like the casual 6v6 domination, the Ground War, which in Cold War is 12v12, and all of those kind of basic Call of Duty game modes, because at the end of the day, that's what I enjoy Call of Duty for. I enjoy it for the standard 6v6 multiplayer experience. Yes, I'll enjoy the zombies from time to time, and yes, I'll play the campaigns maybe once or twice per Call of Duty title, but I'm there for the multiplayer. And even when Warzone just came out and was like the hottest thing on the block and everyone wanted to play the new Call of Duty Battle Royale, even as fun as Warzone was, I still enjoyed the 6v6 and all the game modes that Modern Warfare multiplayer had to offer over Warzone in general. So I think for a player who's very similar to me and really enjoys Call of Duty multiplayer and has for a long time, I think a lot of people will be in the same boat as me and think the exact same way, where Warzone was a novelty and was fun for quite a little bit, but it's starting to wear off. Like that shine of Warzone is starting to wear off. And even during Black Ops 4, when we had Blackout, I still had the same kind of phases where Blackout came out with this thing's incredible, it's brand new, it's a great experience for Call of Duty, and then you get used to it, and then you hit phase 2 where it's okay, I can play Blackout every once in a while, and then you hit phase 3 where it's I don't really want to play Blackout, I've played all of it that it has to offer, I like Battle Royale experiences, but I can only play Blackout with friends now or when I'm really craving it, but for the most part I'm going to stick to multiplayer and zombies and just other game modes within Call of Duty. It happens every time for me with Call of Duty Battle Royales, and keep in mind that there's only been 2, so me saying oh it happens every time really means that it's only happened the 2 times that Call of Duty has had a Battle Royale, and I guess Fortnite too, where Fortnite, when it first came out like way back in 2016-2017, me and Dorito Thief played so much, and I have so many random clips and funny moments saved somewhere on my computer, and then it slowly got a little repetitive, and we would still play for fun, but it was more casual, and then we just started to lose interest and would only play it when we really wanted to play it or had nothing left to play, and then Blackout and all that stuff did the exact same thing. So maybe it's just a Battle Royale issue for me in general, where Battle Royale games don't hold player attention, at least for me, as much as they do for other people. Now, in theory, Battle Royale are extremely replayable games because every single game will play differently. Like, you'll never have a Warzone game that will play the same twice. Like, you will always have different experiences, different loot on the ground, different people you come across. Like, it will be different every time. And the replayability there is huge. But you can only find new scenarios so many times before they start to get similar, and the line between never having the same experience in Warzone twice and experiencing the game so much become blurred, where you know deep down that you'll never have the same experience, but when you play Warzone over and over again consistently, even though what you do in the game will be completely different from your last game, it will still feel the same, and it's kind of losing that spark of wow, this is incredible for me. And I really think Warzone would be amazing if the Cold War integration didn't happen, if they consistently added more playlists and had balancing in the game and didn't have hackers and cheaters 24/7. If they took care of these issues, I think Warzone would still be amazing. Even if Cold War's integration never happened, I would still go back to Modern Warfare just to play Warzone from time to time. Hell, even 3-4 months ago during school, I was always hopping on Warzone after class with the boys just to play a little bit. And when I was doing the DM Ultra grind, the second I finished the DM Ultra grind, the first thing I did before I made my DM Ultra grind video and the guides and all that stuff, the first thing I did was I took DM Ultra into Warzone and played Warzone with the boys. So Warzone has the potential to still be amazing and kind of rebound from the stale state it's in right now, but it needs to make some changes, at least for me. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Do you guys still enjoy Warzone? Are you guys not playing it anymore? And if you're not playing it anymore, why? And if you are still playing it, are there issues that you are having where it's making the game less interesting? Let me know. Leave a like if you guys did enjoy, dislike if you didn't, there's no hard feelings. Subscribe for more videos in the future. I'm about to head out, and if there is one, I'll see you in the next one. Peace.